Endureth forever, alleluia.
And overthrew Pharaoh
for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Say on me of the Amorites. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Walking of the land of the sun. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
And gave their land for an inheritance. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
An inheritance for Israel is certain. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
For in our humiliation the Lord remembered us. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
And redeemed us from our enemies. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
He that giveth food to all flesh. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Alleluia.
For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray the
Lord.
Thank you.
She shall be called woman. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife, and the two shall be one flesh. And those whom God has joined together let no man put asunder. Do thou also now, O Master, our Lord and our God, send down thy heavenly grace upon these thy servants, Ryan Silouan and Heather Barbara, and grant that this thy handmaid may in all things be pleasing unto her husband, and that this thy servant may love and cherish his wife, that they may live according to thy will. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou didst bless Abraham and Sarah.
Amen.
Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou didst bless Isaac and Rebekah.
Amen.
Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou didst bless Joachim and Anna.
Amen.
Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou didst bless Zechariah and Elizabeth. Which the blessed Helena had when she found the precious cross.
Amen.
Remember them, O Lord our God, as thou dost remember thy 40 holy martyrs, sending down upon them crowns from heaven.
Amen.
Remember them, O Lord our God, and the parents who have nurtured them, for the prayers of parents make firm the foundations of houses.
Amen.
Remember, O Lord our God, thy servants, the attendants of the bridal pair who share in this joy.
Amen.
Remember, O Lord our God, thy servant Ryan Silouan and thy handmaid Heather Barbara, and bless them.
Amen.
Grant them fair children and concord of soul and body. Exalt them like the cedars of Lebanon, like a luxuriant vine. that having sufficiency in all things, they may abound in every work that is good and acceptable unto thee. And let them behold their children's children round about their table, like a newly planted olive orchard, that obtaining favor in thy sight, they may shine like the stars of heaven in thee, our Lord and God. For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father who is from everlasting, and to the Son, and to thy life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the
Lord. Lord, have mercy.
O holy God, who didst create man out of the dust, and didst fashion his wife and join her unto him as a helpmate. For it seemed good to thy majesty that man should not be alone upon the earth. As the same Lord, extend thy hand from thy holy dwelling place, and join this thy servant, Ryan Silouan, and this thy handmaid, Heather Barbary. For by thee is the husband united unto the wife. Unite them in one mind and one flesh. Grant them fair children for education in thy faith and fear. For thine is the majesty and the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Servant of God, Ryan Silouan, is crowned to the handmaid of God, Heather Barbara, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The servant of God, Ryan Silouan, is crowned unto the handmaid of God, Heather Barbara, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The servant of God, Ryan Silouan, is crowned unto the handmaid of God, Heather Barbara, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The handmaid of God, Heather Barbara, is crowned to the servant of God, Ryan Silouan, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Is crowned unto the servant of God, Ryan Silouan, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The handmaid of God, Heather Barbara, is crowned unto the servant of God, Ryan Silouan, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Oh.
gladden them in joy with thy countenance.
From the Epistle of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Ephesians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, give thanks always for all things unto God and the Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband.
Peace be to you, reader.
When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to him,
They had no wine. Jesus said to her, O woman, what have I to do with you? My hour has not yet come. His mother said to the servants, Do whatever he tells you. Now the steward of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, Every man serves the good wine first, and when men have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now. This, the first of his signs, Jesus did at Cana in Galilee, and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Amen. Christ is in our midst.
He is in our shall be.
Today, beloved, today you're right in heaven. Heaven and earth come together. Today we are here in Omaha, Nebraska, on a beautiful November afternoon, celebrating the coming together of two beautiful young people. And yet, something else is happening here, something very profound, something very significant. Heaven has entered. Heaven is here. And heaven is here to transform earth and to heal it, and to mold it and to shape it into something that it was always supposed to be. We read the gospel story of our Lord's first miracle in Cana of Galilee for a reason, not only because he was at a wedding, but really because there was something much more profound happening there. Heaven had entered that earthly marriage. Heaven, God in the flesh, had come to attend that marriage. And because of the very presence of God in the flesh, and a little bit of help with it from his mother, mother of God, who told the servants, do whatever he tells you, a miracle happened. That miracle where the Lord Jesus took water and changed it into wine, transformed it. And our Lord is here today. Heaven is here today, desiring to do the same thing to you and for you. For whenever the Lord enters into earth, whenever he enters into our earthly space and time, of course, that great event of the incarnation where God became flesh and dwelt among us, God is still dwelling among us. That's why we say Christ is the Lord. But not only in a generic kind of way, but in a very personal way. Very personal and intimate kind of way. And that's why he is here today. Because he's come at your request. He's come to be here with you, to bless your marriage, to put his hands upon you, and to bring his healing grace to both of you. And to create something that was not there before, as we know. But in order for that to happen, not only the presence of God has to be there, but two willing and desirous people who desire the grace of God, who desire the healing of God, who desire his mercy in their lives, who desire with all their hearts for him to transform their relationship into a thing of the kingdom. And that's exactly what's happening here. When you met several months ago, how long has it been now?
When we first Okay, over 3 years ago. When you met, you started to get to know each other and asking questions and so forth. Probably at the time, you thought it was just kind of on this plane, right? Little did you know that as your hearts opened up to each other, and as the Lord poured out his grace upon you, that this day would come. I think maybe the dawning awareness began to be there more and more as time went on. But that's, isn't that just like our God, to do a work like that in you? And so he brought you through much preparation to this day, because he is here, and by his presence here, he can work a miracle, but he has to work a miracle in a prepared context, in a situation where there is something to work a miracle with, right? There was the water at the wedding of Cana. There was our Lord's presence there. There was the obedience of the servants who filled up the stone jars. And then our Lord came and did his miracle. Everything was prepared. Likewise, in your lives, beloved, everything has been prepared for this day. Your hearts, your minds, your emotions, everything that you are, everything that God has made you, your gifts, your talents, everything you have, the Lord has used to prepare for this day, to begin this good work of creating this new home, this new entity, this new reality. And the Lord will continue that work, as he does with all marriages, for those who have the eyes to see that and the ears to hear that, and the faith to embrace that. So I call upon you today to embrace Christ Jesus with all of your hearts in a new and deeper way. And he will continue that good work that he's begun in you, bringing to mind the things that you heard already. St. Paul giving us the charge, especially us husbands, loving our wives as Christ loved the church. But you know, the beautiful thing, the blessed thing about that, right, is that, and we talked about this before, you don't have to choose between God and heaven. Because by loving her, you are loving God. By serving her, by laying down your life for her, you are loving God. You are fulfilling your call. And of course, there'll be times when you'll stumble and fall, just like all of us do. But because you are the image of Christ, the icon of Christ in this relationship, you will know that it's important to ask for forgiveness, to humble yourself, to empty yourself, so to speak, as Christ did when he came to this earth. So that the healing grace of God and the mercy of God and that wine of sweet love will continue to flow. Heather, you're not getting off either. Ryan may have a very challenging task ahead of him, which he does. But Heather, you also have a wonderful task ahead of you, but also a challenge. Because there will be times when you will be tempted not to see Christ in Ryan, and times when you'll want to resist that, and times when you may just, you know, flat out say no. That's why St. Paul asks you, all right, actually he exhorts us and encourages us to reverence your husband, to treat him as the church treats Christ, for he is our Lord and our Master. He is our bridegroom, the one who heals us, the one who saves us, the one who lifts us up and brings us into a reality, a new reality that meant that your role is able to be, of course. But throughout that journey, it is one that is full of difficulties sometimes. That's why you're here today. That's why you're here. That's not why you're somewhere else. You've come before God. You've come and placed your lives before him and before all of these friends and relatives and loved ones, saying to the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of darkness, the kingdoms of this world, you are saying, we proclaim this day that God is with us, that he's done a work in us, and he's continuing to do that wonderful work of healing, bringing together and creation of one flesh. And the kingdom of God will shine through you. And that is your calling together, to proclaim to the world who Christ is and what his kingdom is all about. So be lovely and beautiful and fragrant icons of Christ to each other, to the world. So that when everyone sees you, that fragrant aroma from life to life, as St. Paul said, will be attractive. And they will look at you and they will say, God is doing the work there. And if they don't know it's God, then they may ask you. And of course, at that point, you'll say, yes, the Lord is doing a good work in this. You have heard many prayers so far and many blessings, and you'll continue to hear more. May your journey be filled with the joy of the Lord, for that is your strength. May your journey be filled with the peace of Christ, which passes all understanding. That gift from God, that peace from above that we pray for earlier. May your journey be filled with the grace of God abundantly, so that you might be changed and transformed. You become more and more like Christ. In thought, word, and deed every day. In the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Let us say with all our soul, with all our mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy upon us, O God, according to thy great mercy. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the servants of God, Ryan Silouan and Heather Barbara, and their parents and their attendants, and all here present.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, our God, with thy saving providence, this vouchsafed by thy presence in Kingdom of Galilee, to declare marriage honorable, do thou the same, Lord, also now maintain in peace and concord thy servants, Ryan Silouan and Heather Barbara. Grant them to lead an upright and blameless life, even unto a ripe old age, walking in thy commandments with a pure heart. For thou art a merciful God who lovest mankind, and unto thee do we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation, we may dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God, as Father, and to say, Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Thou hast made. Bless now with thy spiritual blessing this common cup, which thou dost give to those who are now united in community of marriage. For blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
walking in peace and keeping the commandments of God and righteousness. And you were right. Be exalted like Sarah and exalted like Rebecca. And multiply like Rachel. And rejoice in your husband, fulfilling the conditions of the law, for so it is well pleasing.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, our God, who has come to Cana of Galilee and blessed there the marriage feast, bless also these thy servants, who through thy good providence are now united together in wedlock. Bless their goings out and their comings in. Replenish their life with good things. Receive their crowns into thy kingdom, reserving them spotless, blameless, and without reproach. Now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the all-holy, consubstantial, and life-giving Trinity, one Godhead and one kingdom, bless you, grant unto you length of days, fair children, prosperity of life and faith, and fill you with abundance of all earthly good things, and make you worthy to obtain the blessings of the promise. Through the prayers of the Holy Theotokos and of all the saints.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Declare marriage to be an honorable estate, Christ, our true God, through the prayers of his all-holy mother, of the holy, glorious, and all-laudable apostles, of the holy God-crowned kings and saints equal to the apostles Constantine and Helena, of the holy great martyr Procopius, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Amen. Amen.
Brian, the moment you've been waiting. And kiss your bride.
Protect them for many years.
God.